Today I'm going to do Caleb's challenge inspired by Tessa's video. And I have 10 songs to get through, so I'm just gonna go ahead and jump right in. Also, these songs are in no particular order. Number 1.
I thought that I had everybody on my side, but I went and blew it all sky high.
SpongeBob SquarePants is a weird show. It stars a kitchen sponge who lives in a pineapple with his pet snail. His neighbors are a starfish who literally lives under a rock, and an octopus who for some reason is named Squidward. He works for a greedy crab who has a whale for a daughter and a plankton for a rival. And he's also friends with a squirrel who wears a spacesuit so that she can live underwater. This is a truly bizarre show. And this show has weirdly good songs. Considering what kind of show it is, these songs have no right being as good as they are. It's difficult to narrow it down to just one, and honestly, you could probably just include all the SpongeBob songs on this playlist, and you would have a pretty good listening experience. However, I was able to narrow it down to this one. Ripped Pants is actually the very first original song that was written for SpongeBob, and it was a very good indication of what was to come when it comes to original songs. It's catchy, has a nice beat to it, and it also just has a really good message. And I can't help but smile every time that I hear it. Number 2. When I was in college, I was a part of a theater fraternity called Theta Alpha Phi. We had two masks over the school year, and without fail, a lot of the songs played at those masks were all 80s and 90s dance music. And as a result, I acquired quite a taste for them in my 3 years of being a part of the organization. So I absolutely loved this song when it first came out and Abby showed it to me. This song is very clearly 80s inspired, and it is, in my opinion, one of the best dance songs ever written. It's just such a bop, and I am always just overjoyed to dance around like an idiot whenever it comes on. Another reason why this song gives me the happies is the music video, which I highly recommend checking out. The music video is also very clearly 80s inspired, and it's just completely ridiculous, and I just love it so, so much. Number 3.
Hit it! I need a hero!
All right, big fella, let's crash this party!
Yes, I am specifically referring to the version from Shrek 2. Here's the thing, I had never heard this song before I watched this movie, which means that I really only associate this song with Shrek 2, which I suppose means I should have included in my movie association video. Oh well. I absolutely love Shrek 2. In my opinion, I think it's better than the first one. And this entire sequence is one of the best parts of the movie. I love the juxtaposition of Prince Charming dancing with Fiona while Shrek and Co. try to ride in to stop Charming and Fiona from kissing. So it's this kind of representation of Prince Charming as the ideal hero, which the fairy godmother is very clearly trying to paint him as, with this showing of Shrek being the actual hero. This scene always gives me a smile, and I'm always happy when I watch it, which means that I'm always happy when I hear this song. Number 4.
It's in the singing of a street corner choir. It's going home and getting warm by the fire. It's true, wherever you find love, it feels like Christmas.
Muppet Christmas Carol is, in my mind, the best Christmas movie. It's one of the few Christmas movies that I will always watch every year around Christmas time. And if there is a single song from this movie that will always give me the warm fuzzies when I hear it, it's this one. It feels like Christmas is just such a perfect feel-good song. It represents everything that I feel Christmas should be. It's a time for love and giving and just being kind to your fellow human beings. This song just feels like a big hug to me, honestly, and I just love listening to it. As one YouTube commenter said on a video of this song, "This song can always put me in a good mood, no matter what." that. And that is a sentiment that I agree with full-heartedly.
It feels like Christmas.
Number five. About the song before in my top 10 Tom Chapin songs from a few years ago. It was actually number one, and it was covered on this channel a couple years before that. So I probably won't spend too much time talking about it here. However, for those who haven't seen that video, I will just say that the song is ridiculous. It tells the love story of a battle beast and a Barbie that ends in tragedy. It's pretty much the kind of story that you would expect a child to come up with that are playing with toys, so they have a literal Barbie and little Battle Beast, and just, you know, creating a love story between them. But in the universe of the song, everything that's happening is just played so seriously, which just kind of adds to the ridiculousness. There is a reason why I rank this as my number one Tom Chapin song, so it just kind of made sense to include it here. Number six.
So you're saying that you don't have rhythm, but listen what you're doing right there. With that stamp and a book, you got a real nice hook. Sounds to me like you got rhythm to spare.
I did not grow up with Phineas and Ferb. I didn't really watch the Disney Channel growing up, and also this show came out when I was in high school. However, I did very recently watch through all of it because of Disney Plus, and it is a show that I do highly recommend checking out. Like SpongeBob, there are a lot of good songs to choose from. Unlike SpongeBob, there is literally a song in every single episode, and there are 189 episodes, and all of them are good. And that's not even talking about the two movies, so, you know, there's a few more options. However, I was finally able to settle on this song, I Ain't Got Rhythm. As a percussionist myself, I always enjoy a song with a good beat. And this song, by its very nature, has one of those. The basic premise of the episode where this song comes from is that Phineas and Ferb are trying to get the band Love Handle back together for their parents' anniversary. This specific song, the best one from the episode, is them trying to convince the drummer to come back. This drummer, unfortunately, believes that he has no rhythm, despite all the evidence to the contrary. That premise alone, honestly, is enough to give me the happies. But the song itself is also just so masterfully done, from the drummer's just absolute refusal to believe that he has any sort of rhythm, to Phineas's complete disbelief at everything going on around him. The song is just a bop, and it's hilarious, and I love it. Number seven. When I'm feeling lonely, sad as I can be, all by myself in uncharted island in an endless sea. Back to shows that I actually did watch as a child, we have My Shiny Teeth and Me from The Fairly Odd Parents. The Fairly Odd Parents was another weird show, I watched a lot of those as a child, and this song is also very strange. It's Chip Skylark, famed boy band type singer in the Fairly Odd Parents universe, singing about how much he loves his teeth. It's a weird song, but it's also catchy as all hell, and constantly gets stuck in my head. And I'm never mad about it, which makes sense, considering I'm talking about it on this list. And it would kind of ruin the point of this list if I were mad about it. So, you know. Mix in quite a bit of nostalgia, and you have a song that will always make me smile. My shiny teeth and me. My shiny teeth and me. My shiny teeth and me. Number eight. It's no secret that I love Weird Al Yankovic. I mean, I did a whole video on the guy 3 years ago. In my mind, he can do no wrong, and he has written a lot of songs in the many years that he's been active that gives me serotonin. There's no doubt in my mind, however, that the one that is my favorite and the one that I was always going to talk about in this video is White and Nerdy. I've always felt that this song could just be my anthem, because I, too, am very white and very nerdy. I also feel the song just does a really good job of emphasizing just how good Weird Al is at everything. He says a lot of words in not a lot of time, and I don't understand how he's able to do that. And like with Shut Up and Dance With Me, I also have to mention the music video that comes along with this song. Weird Al took an already fantastic song and just made it better with the music video. I also just love all the cameos in this video, from Key and Peele at the very beginning to the very brief shot of Seth Green to Donny Osmond. So much Donny Osmond. And it's just, it's so great. But oh well, it's obvious I'm wide and nerdy. I think I'm just too wide and nerdy. I think I'm just too wide and nerdy. I'm just too wide and nerdy. Look at me, I'm wide and nerdy. Number 9.
She's touching my hand.
He's looking kinda funny.
Wait, does she think I like her?
Is this because I touched his hand?
First things first, this song does contain spoilers for the musical Spies Are Forever by the Tin Can Brothers. Spies Are Forever is a musical that I very strongly recommend. You can watch it for free on their YouTube channel, and it's a really good musical. With all that being said, let's talk about this song. I love absolutely everything about this song. I love the harmonies between the two characters. I love how wildly uncomfortable both of these characters are. And I love how this song tackles heteronormativity. The basic premise of this song is that the two main spies of the musical, Kurt Mega and Tatiana, are singing about how clearly they should be together. Because after all, they're a guy and a girl, and they're both spies, so obviously they need to end up together. But there's literally no attraction coming from either side. They're just feeling this pressure because it's what they're supposed to do in this situation. And also, Kurt's gay, and this musical takes place in the 1960s, so he's also dealing with all of that. This song is hilarious because it completely subverts the idea of heteroromances needing to take place in spy movies and also just movies and stories in general. And it's also heartwarming because, at the end, Tatiana accepts Kurt for who he is. And as a result, the friendship between the two of them grows even stronger.
I'm happy to have you as my friend.
Number 10.
You gotta kick it up a notch if you're ever gonna reach your goal.
There is something about a good villain song that will always give me the happies. Now, StarKid, the company that gave us a very Potter musical back in 2009 and has given us pretty much gold ever since, for the most part with a few exceptions, has written a lot of stellar villain songs over the years. However, it's this song from the musical Starship, written 10 years ago, that still sticks in my head as my favorite. It's kind of hard to explain why I like it so much. It's the sort of laid-back, jazzy feel that the song has to it. It's the fact that Pinsir, the main villain who's singing the song, is so obviously evil and is barely trying to hide it, and yet Bug, our well-meaning but very stupid protagonist, just doesn't seem to get it. It's the fact that it's a really fun song to sing. It's the fact that it's sung by Dylan Saunders, one of my favorite members of Team StarKid. It's just, it's all of these things and more. Also, I didn't mention this at the beginning when I first started talking about the song, but Starship is also a musical that you can go check out for free on YouTube, this one on the StarKid channel, and it is another musical that I do recommend.
Let's kick it up a notch.
Kick it up a notch.
So at last, I'll have human me.
So with that is 10 songs that give me serotonin. This video has already gone on quite some time, so I'm just gonna wrap it up here. Hope you all enjoyed these selections, and I will see all of you tomorrow.